Hello everyone, this is John Falk with Jack Success, and today we're going to be covering a topic in Calculus 1. We're going to be taking the derivatives of inverse trig functions. So first off, we're going to work with sine inverse. So we're going to say y equals the sine inverse of x. Now the trick that we're going to use here is we're going to take the sine of both sides. So we're going to say the sine of y equals the sine of the sine inverse of x. And if you remember from pre-cal, if you take the function of an inverse function, all you get out is x. So we will get sine of y equals x. So now we will take the derivative of both sides, and remember the left side you have to implicitly differentiate. So we will have the cosine of y times dy dx equals derivative of x is just 1. So if we solve for dy dx, we get dy dx equals 1 over cosine of y. So now we will construct our triangle right here. We're going to call this angle y, and we know that the sine of y is x over 1. So, the sine of y is opposite over hypotenuse. So this side, with Pythagorean theorems, is we get the square root of 1 squared, which is just 1, minus x squared. So if we look at the cosine of y, we get 1 minus x squared over 1, which is adjacent over hypotenuse. So our derivative, dy dx, is equal to 1 over the square root of 1 minus x squared. And that's the derivative of sine inverse. So now we will move on to the cosine inverse. So the cosine inverse of x, if we use our same trick, we take the cosine of both sides, we get the cosine of y equals the cosine of the cosine inverse of x. So on the left we have the cosine of y equals, and if we take the cosine of the cosine inverse of x, we simply get x. So if we differentiate both sides, remembering that the left side we have to implicitly differentiate, we get negative sine of y, which is the derivative of cosine of y, times dy dx equals, and the derivative of x is simply 1. So if we solve for dy dx, we get negative 1 over the sine of y. Now let's construct our triangle again. And our angle is going to be y. And we know that the cosine of y is x over 1. So that's adjacent over hypotenuse. So with Pythagorean theorem, we get this side to be 1 squared, which is 1, minus x squared. So if we plug that in right here, we get our derivative is equal to negative 1 over, and the sine of x, or the sine of y, I'm sorry, is opposite over hypotenuse, which is simply the square root of 1 minus x squared. Okay, and now we will move to the tangent inverse. Tangent inverse of x. And with this, it's no different. We're still going to take the tangent of both sides. Tangent of the tangent inverse of x. So on the left-hand side, we get tangent of y equals, and then the tangent of the tangent inverse of x is simply x. If we implicitly differentiate the left side, the derivative of tangent is secant squared of y times dy dx equals derivative of x is just 1. So if we solve for dy dx, we get 1 over secant squared of y. So let's construct our triangle once again. With our angle being y, and we know that the tangent of y is x over 1. The tangent is opposite over adjacent. So due to Pythagorean theorem, we get this side to be x squared plus 1 squared, which is just 1. So we get secant of y to be, see, secant is 1 over cosine. So instead of adjacent over hypotenuse, we get hypotenuse over adjacent, which is the square root of x squared plus 1 over 1. So we get our derivative to be 1 over the square root of x squared plus 1 and squared, since that's squared. So our derivative is 1 over x squared plus 1. And that's the derivative of tangent inverse of x.